top four answers on the board. We ask 100 men, name a way a woman is like a roller coaster ride.
She's up and down.
All up and down. Pass the point. Okay, Tess, we asked 100 men, probably some really nice guys, name a way a woman is like a roller coaster ride.
Nookie, Steve.
Nookie. Tony, only one strike. We talked to 100 men. Name a way a woman is like a roller coaster ride.
There's a lot of twists and turns.
You better know it is. It's a lot of twists and turns. Kevin, we've got two strikes. We got to pull it together now. If it's not there, the other family can steal and win. We asked 100 men, name a way a woman is like a roller coaster ride.
Let's go with really fast.
Nice stuff.
She's really fast. Eva, we got two strikes. We got to be careful now. If it's not there, the other family can steal and win the game. Talk to 100 men. Name a way a woman is like a roller coaster ride.
She's crazy.
She's crazy. Family, here is the situation. I got two answers on this board. You give me either one of those answers, your family steals. Your family wins a game. You can keep talking about it. I got stuff to do here. But if it's not there, the Noble family wins the game. This does it right here. We ask 100 men, name a way a woman is like a roller coaster ride.
Steve, she makes you scream.
Boy, let me tell you something. Or not, but I want to thank the Lord for that answer. If you ain't ever had one make you scream, you got to try it sometime.
I know that's right.
What does he mean by make you scream? Y'all got to talk that over. They want to know what you mean. Make sure.
She's exciting.
She's exciting! Number three. Top five answers on the board. A cheating husband would be mortified if his wife had him served with divorce papers where? Charisse.
At his job.
At his job.
Good answer!
Daniel, a cheating husband would be mortified if his wife served him divorce papers where?
I'm gonna say at the bar.
At the bar. Ashley, a husband would be mortified if his divorce papers were served to him where?
At his mistress' house.
Yeah! At the mistress' house. Arvella, husband be mortified if wife served divorce papers where?
At the doctor's office.
At the doctor's office. Yeah. Husband be mortified if his wife had him served with divorce papers.
I'm gonna say at a sporting event.
At a sporting event?
Oh, yeah!
Oh. All right, family, a cheating husband would be mortified if his wife had him served with divorce papers where?
We're gonna say at his friend's house.
At his friend's house. Number five.
His Alzheimer's.
Four.
Home on rapper.
Three. Top six answers on the board. Name a reason you might remove your pants quickly. Jerron.
Going to bed.
Going to bed.
Have sex.
Have sex. Garrison, name a reason you might remove your pants quickly.
Getting in the shower.
Getting in the shower. MG, name a reason you might remove your pants quickly.
Going to the bathroom.
Confidence. Going to the bathroom. Miss Faith, name a reason you might remove your pants quickly.
Because you're hot, to cool off. Because you're hot.
Because you're hot. Brian, give me a reason you might remove your pants quickly.
Just because you're in a hurry.
Because you're in a hurry. We got two strikes now, Emily. We got to slow it down a little bit now. We got the Tucker family over there. They can steal. Emily, give me a reason you might remove your pants quickly.
You're changing clothes, Steve.
Changing clothes. Name a reason you might remove your pants quickly.
Because you spilt something on them.
You spilled something on them. Number three. Two.
On fire.
Top eight answers on the board. Name something that might be all over a woman.
Clothes.
Clothes.
Jewelry.
Jewelry. Ellen?
I don't know how to say this elegantly, but
what she said. Lily?
I am gonna go with nothing.
Ooh. Nothing.
Lotion.
Lotion. Cameron?
Paint.
Paint.
Okay. Paint. Yeah, paint.
Paint! Pass the point.
Now we want to play, Steve! Yeah!
Okay, hey, Anna.
Yes, sir.
Name something that might be all over a woman.
I'm gonna go with chocolate, Steve.
Chocolate! Hey,
I'm...
Molly.
Hey.
Name something that might be all over a woman.
A man.
Ooh. A man. Hey, Amy.
Hey.
Name something that might be all over a woman.
I'm gonna go with perfume.
Oh. Perfume. Name something that might be all over woman. Before you answer this question, try to find an eloquent way to say this one.
I've got a cleaner one.
Name something that might be all over a woman.
Hair.
Oh, good answer.
Give me something that might be all over a woman.
All right, Steve, I'm gonna try whipped cream.
Ooh. Whipped cream. All right, we got two strikes. Two family can steal, folks. We gotta be careful. Anna?
I'm gonna go with tattoos.
Tattoos. Hey, Molly, something that might be all over a woman. We got two strikes, gotta be careful.
Glitter?
Glitter, yeah! Glitter! Name something that might be all over a woman.
Children.
Children! That was a good one. Five.
Makeup.
Three.
Skin.
Top six answers on the board. Tell me a part of your body no one has ever kissed. Okay.
My behind.
My behind.
Yeah. My nose.
My nose.
We're gonna play, Steve.
This is an interesting question. I personally have no answers for you. I'm 65. I've led a full life.
Right.
Matter of fact, number two, I don't even know how that's up there. I can't tell you how many people I've asked to kiss that. Kay, how you doing?
I'm doing good, Steve.
All right, tell me what you do again.
I'm a comedian, and I'm actually going to be at Punchline Philly this Wednesday.
Well, I wish you were. It seems like you ought to be up. Good luck at the Punchline.
Thank you. I appreciate
Thank
that.
Thank you. All right. Chris, how you doing, David?
Hey, I'm doing great, Steve.
Good. Remind me what you do again.
I'm a comedian as well. Me and my sister, we've been doing our shows.
Well, good luck to you, man.
Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Tell me a part of your body no one has ever kissed.
My feet.
Yeah. Your feet. Kiki, tell me a part of your body no one has ever kissed.
I'm gonna say your legs.
Your legs. Done some of my best work. Your leg. Girl. Your leg.
Yeah.
Leg, knee, ankle. Right behind the knee? Boy, stop. Reggie?
Steve?
Yeah, so how long you been a comedian?
I'm not even a comedian, man. I'm a truck driver.
My man.
I'm a
Come
truck
on,
driver,
dog.
Man. Today, man.
That's
truck
right, Reggie.
Driver, man.
All right, Reggie, tell me a part of your body no one has ever kissed.
I'm gonna go with my back.
Your back. Only one strike. Hey, Rob, tell me a part of your body nobody's ever kissed.
I'm gonna say the ear, my ears.
Your ear. Your ear. You got two strikes, Kay. You gotta be careful. Two family can steal. Tell me a part of your body no one has ever kissed.
I'm gonna say my elbow.
My elbow. All right, Chris. Tell me, two strikes. You gotta be careful. Two family can steal. Part of your body no one's ever kissed.
I'm gonna say my eyes, Steve. My eyes.
Your eyes. Top six answers on the board. Besides washing your body, name something you do in the shower. Ray Dean.
Shave.
Shave.
Hair. Wash your hair.
Wash your hair.
Play.
Seth, besides washing your body, something you do in the shower?
Sing.
Sing.
Yeah.
Jamie, you ready?
I think so.
Okay, listen carefully.
Okay.
Besides washing your body.
Oh.
Name something you do in the shower. It should be no misunderstanding that. Jamie?
Stand there, enjoy the quiet.
Stand there and enjoy the quiet. Christopher?
Yeah.
Besides washing your body, name something you do in the shower.
You have sex, Steve.
Hey, man.
What's up?
JoJo, I don't know what's happening.
Mr. Steve.
This boy down here, he gonna mess around and get put out the face.
Wow. Mr. Steve.
Woo. Have sex.
It's up there.
Yeah! Besides washing your body, name something you do in the shower.
Clean your nails.
Clean your nails. All right, we got two strikes, Ray Dean. We gotta be careful. Scott family could steal. Besides washing your body, name something you do in the shower.
I'm gonna wash the tub and shower.
Just gonna go in there and wash it. All right, family, besides washing your body, name something you do in the shower.
Brush your teeth.
Something you do in the shower.
Pee.
Pee!
Yeah.
Number six.
Yes, Pee.
Top eight answers on the board. We asked 100 men. Oh, we asked 100 men. This is gonna be so good. Name something your wife wears to bed now that she didn't wear when you were dating. Sam.
Lingerie.
Lingerie.
Good answer.
I'm gonna go with an old raggedy t-shirt.
An old raggedy t-shirt. Jake.
We'll say a sleep mask.
A sleep mask. Abby?
I'm gonna go with a...
Yeah, you'll go with it next game. Tyson, talk to 100 men. Name something your wife wears to bed now that she didn't wear when you were dating.
Clothes.
More specific. You have to be more specific.
A nightgown.
Good answer.
A nightgown. That nightgown with all the fuzz balls on it. TJ, you don't even know what the hell we're talking about,
no
but
clue.
Name something your wife wears to bed now that she didn't wear when you were dating.
I'm gonna say one of those CPAPs, the mouth things that helps you breathe.
A CPAP that helps you breathe.
Come on, Steve.
That can work.
Come on.
That's way too scientific of an answer.
Come on.
A CPAP.
Come on.
We only got one strike, Scott. Hey, man, 100 men, name something your wife wears to bed now she didn't wear when you were dating.
How about hair curlers?
Hair curlers. All that. Hair curlers. we're missing some good ones here. Come on, Sam, we gotta pull it together. The women can steal.
I'm gonna go with underwear.
Panties is here. Granny panties is here. Jake, 100 men, name something your wife wears to bed now that she didn't wear when you were dating.
I want to go with earplugs.
Good answer.
What?
Yeah.
Earplugs! We asked 100 men, name something your wife wears to bed now that she didn't wear when you were dating.
We're gonna go with sweatpants,
yes.
Steve.
Yes. 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 Sweatpants. Eight. Mm-hmm. Seven. You was close, man. You was close. You was close. Four.
Sweatpants.
Three.
Wool socks.
Top seven answers on the board. This is a fill in the blank. I took a sledgehammer to my talking mirror on the wall because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all. Kelly.
Ugliest.
Ugliest. Okay, this is a fill in the blank. I took a sledgehammer to my mirror on the wall because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all.
Wrinkliest. With the most wrinkles.
Wrinkliest! Shannon. Took a sledgehammer to my talking mirror because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all.
Fattest?
Nice. Yes.
Fattest. My man, Money Man, took a sledgehammer to my mirror because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all.
Hairiest, Steve.
Obviously, I wouldn't know what you're talking about. Hairiest. All right, we got one strike now, Kristen. We got to be, well, we okay, don't worry about it. Took a sledgehammer to my mirror because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all.
I'm the meanest of them
all. Yes.
Meanest. Kelly, took a sledgehammer to my mirror because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all.
If mirrors could smell, the smelliest?
Yes! Yes!
Good answer.
Yes.
Good answer.
Smelliest!
Oh, okay.
All right, we got two strikes now, Sandy. We gotta be careful. The McKellum family can steal. Took a sledgehammer to my mirror because it kept saying I was the blankest.
The dumbest.
Yes.
The dumbest.
Oh, yeah.
The dumbest. All right, Shannon, we got two strikes. The Kellum family can steal.
The baldest?
Yes! Yes! Oh. Yes! Yes!
So, Shannon.
Nothing personal.
Well, I'm really personal, but you just thought you'd just go with the baldest. The baldest! I took a sledgehammer to my talking mirror on the wall because it kept saying I was the blankest of them all.
We're gonna go with the craziest of them all!
Let's go!
Let's go!
The craziest!
Let's go!
It's up there, Steve. What?
It's up there.
Okay. Number six.
Shortest.
Number five. Top seven answers on the board. Listen carefully. Name a cute animal that makes a cute nickname for a cute woman. Melissa.
Monkey.
Monkey. Hey, monkey.
Panda.
Hey, panda.
have one question. Yeah.
Danielle, cute animal makes a cute nickname for a cute woman.
Kitten.
Kitten. Sharon, cute animal, cute nickname for a cute woman.
I'm gonna say puppy.
Hey, puppy. Karen, cute animal, cute nickname for a cute woman.
Chicky.
Chicky. Ken, you ain't gonna know this one. Come on, boy. Ken, you got to pull out that old player card, man, you used to have.
You
Ken,
know.
Ken, come on, man. Name a cute animal, make a cute nickname for a cute woman.
A hamster.
Good answer, Steve. Come on now.
Great answer.
Hell yeah.
Great answer.
Yeah. Yeah. Good answer.
Ooh, come on, you little fat little hamster. Hamster. Chris, name a cute animal, makes a cute nickname for a cute woman.
Bunny.
Chris, I'm surprised. I ain't know you had it in you, man. You ain't had fun all damn day. Bunny! Danielle, name a cute animal, makes a cute nickname for a cute woman.
Piggy.
Hey, fellas, listen to me. Don't try that at your house. Hey, little piggy. You ain't gonna be able to fix this, fellas. Piggy! All right, we got two strikes. We gotta be careful now, Sharon. The Crosby family can steal.
Horsey.
Hey, come on, Horsey. Come on over here. Horsey. All right, family, give me a cute animal that makes a cute nickname for a cute woman.
All right. Lamb.
Number six.
Otter.
What? Who's ever called a woman an otter? Number five. Top four answers on the board. We asked 100 women. It irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
Get dressed.
Get dressed. Come on.
Come on,
Deja. Deja, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
So what do you do for a living?
I am a graphics and social media producer for MSNBC show Politics Nation with Reverend Al Sharpton.
I just had Reverend Al on my show this morning.
Your radio show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he was talking about the 57th anniversary of the March on Washington.
He's doing the march today. Yes.
He's doing it today.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's pretty good, man. All right, good. When we ask 100 women, it irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
When you having sex.
What did you sex? When a guy takes longer to do than you. All right, sex! Sandra, we asked 100 women, it irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
Finish his chores, Steve.
Finish his chores. Dale, only one strike. Talk to 100 women. It irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
Eat.
Eat. Chrissy, listen to this. If it's there, your family plays sudden death.
Okay.
If it's not there, you're still alive, only one strike. We ask 100 women, it irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
Say, I love you, Steve.
Well, you're gonna be mad a lot of times. Say, I love you for sudden death.
Let's go.
Wanda, we got one answer left. If it's there, your family gets to play sudden death. But this time you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and win the game. To Wanda, talk to 100 women. It irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
Cook.
Family, here is the situation. There's one answer and one answer only. If it's there, your family steals, your family wins the game. If it's not there, the Sanderlin family gets to play sudden death. Here we go. We ask 100 women, it irritates you when a guy takes longer to do what than you?
Go to the bathroom, Steve.
Go to the bathroom for the win.
Go.
Top seven answers on the board. Name someone's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead. Damone.
Your ex.
Your ex. Cheryl, name someone's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
My old boss.
Your boss?
Yeah.
Good job.
Jerome, my man, came in here and validated the story of how I met my wife that night in the comedy club. You know how I was talking about this? You're the first person I've met that was dead. I've never met anybody that was dead.
Oh, cool.
Never, man. That's a big moment.
Yes.
All right, Deron, name someone's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
Your enemy.
Your enemy.
Answer.
Candace, name somebody's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
Not me, Steve, personally, but my in-law.
Good answer. Good answer.
Your in-laws. Courtney, name someone's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
Let's say someone you owe something to.
Damn. I owe you some money. Let me go down here and make sure I don't owe you. I'm gonna go down here and make sure I don't owe you no more. Oh, yeah, that's him. Yep, yep. Somebody you owe something to. Oh. Hey, Deron, only one strike. Give me somebody's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
Someone who owes me money. So I go get it from the rest of the family. They weren't gonna pay it to me, so I'm gonna go.
Oh, they weren't gonna they pay weren't, it to you, so gonna, now you're gonna check with the family.
Yeah, I'm saying he.
So let me get this right. So you're in the funeral line. You get up to the body, you notice it's him. You turn to the family and go, you know he owed me $500. That's pretty trifling, Deron.
It's up there, Steve.
Somebody that owes you money. All right, Cheryl, we got two strikes now, darling. We got to be careful. The Davis family can steal. Name someone's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
The teacher who failed me.
Damn. The teacher that failed you. Damn, wasn't her fault.
No, yes, it was.
Die, heifer.
Yeah. Told me I would never be a teacher.
Give me no F I deserve. You could have passed me. The teacher that failed you. Name someone's funeral you might go to just to make sure they're dead.
A nosy neighbor.
A nosy neighbor. Number 7.
Awful spouse, mates.
6.
My parents.
Damn. Number 4.
Politicians.
Top 7 answers on the board. All right, here we go. Name something you'd like to give away, but no one wants it. Shannon.
My children. Not mine. Like.
Not yours.
Yeah. Like, I don't want to.
No. Name something you'd like to give away, but no one wants it. And you said, my children. That's what you said. Yes. It's okay. It's okay. Give away the damn kids! Tony.
Say clothes.
Clothes. Kenyatta, how you doing today?
I'm doing good, Steve.
All right, y'all, let's get at it. Name something you'd like to give away, but no one wants it.
My wigs.
Good answer.
My wigs. Jay, how you doing today, man?
I'm doing great, Uncle Steve.
Good to see you again. Name something you'd like to give away, but no one wants it.
My old car.
An old car.
Good answer. Good answer.
Taboola?
Yeah.
2 strikes, Callahan Family Castillo. Name something you like to give away, but no one wants it.
My extra pounds.
My extra pounds. That was a really good answer. Name something you like to give away, but no one wants it.
Your old furniture.
Yes.
Yes. Furniture. Number 7.
My fruitcake food.
6.
Dog pets.
Wow. 5. Low model. 4.
Books.
3.
Spouse.
Top 8 answers on the board. It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on a what? Kathy.
A yacht.
A yacht.
Good answer. I'm going to say a horse.
A horse. Hey, David, it might be romantic to propose to a woman riding on a what?
Riding on a Ferris wheel.
Riding on a Ferris wheel. That's pretty good, David. Ferris wheel. Wouldn't have thought of that. It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on a what?
A fancy car. Riding
in a fancy car. It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on what?
A train.
A train. My man JL, how you feeling today, man?
I'm doing great.
All right, man. It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on a what?
Steve, I'm going to have to say a hot air balloon.
Yeah. A hot air balloon. Nancy?
Hey.
It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on a what?
I'm gonna say an airplane.
An airplane! All right, David, we got two strikes. Dyke's family can steal. Might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on what?
Motorcycle.
On a motorcycle! Nicole, we got two strikes. It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on a what?
I'm gonna say a camel.
Riding on a camel! It might be romantic to propose to a woman while riding on a what?
A bus.
Number eight.
Send them by.
Seven.
Dolphin.
What? Top five answers on the board. We ask 100 men, name something you might lie about on the first date that could come back to haunt you. McKinley.
Kids.
Kids.
Your name.
Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
Your name. Caitlin.
Marital status.
Marital status. Matt.
Your job.
Your job.
Play. We will play, Steve.
Yeah! Sheila, how you doing?
I'm doing well, Steve. How about yourself?
I'm good. You look good. Happy. Where y'all from?
We're from Bowie, Maryland, Steve, Bowie. Which is right outside of Washington and Baltimore, right between, right in the middle.
Yeah. Yep. What do you do for a living?
So I'm a reading recovery teacher for Prince George's County Public Schools.
Yeah!
What?
Wait. A
reading recovery teacher. So that's a reading intervention program, and we have 20 weeks to teach those babies how to read. And we do it, Steve! Yeah.
That's good. Jay, how you doing, man?
Good, how are you?
What do you do, Jay?
I'm a firefighter technician for D.C. Fire Department in Washington, D.C.
Firefighter technician?
Yeah. I drive the fire truck.
Oh, you drive the fire truck. Oh, that's a big job, though. You first responder. We appreciate
sir. You. Been there for...
Dan, what do you do?
I'm a university student, Steve. I'm getting my master's in cybersecurity from the University of Maryland, but I'm also a federal law enforcement officer for NASA.
Yeah!
Well, that's pretty good. What do you do, Matt?
Well, Steve, I work for a company called First Pick, and we do project management for youth-serving nonprofits, so helping them get grant funding to serve most of the underserved youth across the country.
Yeah. That's pretty nice. Let's play. Keegan, talk to 100 men. Name something you might lie about on the first date that come back to haunt you.
Your age.
Your age! Hey, Dan. 100 men, something you might lie about on the first date to come back to haunt you.
Having an STD, Steve.
Having an STD. Hey, Jay, 100 men, name something you might lie about on the first date to come back to haunt you.
Your gender.
Your gender. Your gender. We got two strikes now, Sheila. We got to be careful.
All right.
Talk to 100 men. Name something you might lie about on the first date that could come back to haunt you.
Okay, Steve, is income.
Good answer. Good
answer. Your money.
Yeah!
A billionaire.
Yes.
Matt, we got one answer left. You can clear the board, but you got two strikes the other family can steal. 100 men, name something you might lie about on first date, come back to haunt you.
How many people you've slept with?
Yeah, good answer!
How many people you slept with? Top eight answers on the board. Steve Harvey wakes up to find all his hair has grown back. Now, how is he going to style it? Erica.
Cut it back off.
Cut it right back off. Go back ball. Maria?
I in a nice afro.
Hell yeah. Big fro, baby. Okay. Yes, don't worry about that. I'm assuming with the little big afro, curly. Won't be curly though. Boy, I had, well, back in the day, boy, I had a nice one. Uh-huh. Eddie?
Yes, Steve.
Steve Harvey wakes up, his hair grown back. How's he gonna style it?
I see Steve with braids.
Yes!
Braids! Christine, I wake up, I got hair now. How am I gonna style it?
I think you'd get a nice fade.
Fade?
Yeah! Yeah.
But you better know I'd have a fade. Tom, you wake up, I find my hair's grown back. How you think I'm gonna style it?
Steve, I can see you with some waves.
Wait, hell yeah, boy.
Yeah.
I used to have them too, Taj. Taj, I used to have them.
Okay.
Boy, I had a cold wave set.
Yeah.
Nice. Waves. Angel?
I think you might like it enough to grow it longer.
Grow it longer.
Good answer. Yeah.
Grow it longer. Wake up, I've got my hair back. How am I gonna style it?
You're gonna dye your hair, Steve.
I'm gonna dye it.
Good
what
answer,
color?
Good answer.
Good answer.
Red.
Whoa. Whoa.
Dye my hair red. Dennis Rodman. Oh. All right, we got two strikes. Fields family can steal. Eddie?
Mohawk.
Good answer.
Eddie!
Good answer.
Good answer.
A mohawk. Yeah! Christine, darling, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. Fields family can steal. Grow my hair back. How am I going to style it?
Well, Steve, maybe you just might straighten it.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer.
Yeah. I'm back. Straighten it. Well, now, family, Steve Harvey wakes up to find all his hair's grown back now. How does he style it?
They say a mullet. It's up there. It's up there.
The mullet! Number 7. Number 5.
Slick back.
Top 5 answers on the board. Name an animal that walks in a sexy way. Shannon.
A giraffe.
A giraffe.
A cheetah.
A cheetah. Sean.
A fox.
Fox. Yeah. My man, Taj.
A horse.
A horse. Angel, name an animal that walks in a sexy way.
I'm gonna say a little kitty cat.
A little
good
kitty
answer,
cat.
Good answer, good answer, good answer.
A little kitty cat. Maria, give me an animal that walks in a sexy way.
Oh, I think a lion walks in a very sexy way.
Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
A lion. Eddie, give me an animal that walks in a sexy way.
Human being.
Yeah, good answer.
A woman. A sexy. I ain't mad at you, Eddie. I ain't mad at you. A human being, specifically the woman. Christine, give me an animal that walks in a sexy way.
I think maybe a tiger might.
A tiger? Hey, my dude, Charles, you got to say this thing, man. We got two strikes, other family can steal.
A dog.
Dog! Name an animal that walks in a sexy way.
A cougar.
A cougar! Top 8 answers on the board. We asked 100 men to fill in the blank. I like to blank in my underwear. Sam.
Watch TV.
I like to watch TV in my underwear.
Bring it on, Steve.
Darren. Talk to 100 men, fill in the blank. I like to blank in my underwear.
Eat breakfast, Steve.
I like to eat in my underwear. Hey, Shannon, now we talk to 100 men, now fill in the blank. I like to blank in my underwear.
Sleep.
Sleep. Dan, 100 men, fill in the blank. I like to blank in my underwear.
Brush my teeth.
Good.
I like to brush my teeth in my underwear. Miss Shirley, talk to 100 men now. I like to blank in my underwear.
Cook.
Cook. Hey, Sam. We got two strikes. We gotta be careful now. The McKellum family can steal, buddy. Talk to 100 men, fill in the blank. I like to blank in my underwear.
Seduce my woman.
Yeah! Big Sam in here. Since I got my drawers on, what are we doing? Let's get busy. Seduce.
Oh. Okay.
We ask 100 men to fill in the blank. I like to blank in my underwear.
Steve, they see me, so they know I like to dance in my underwear. Let's go! Let's go, Steve!
Men? Six. Five.
Be comfortable.
Four.
Blow air business.
Top 6 answers on the board. Fill in the blank. I wish I had dance moves like who? Dave.
Michael Jackson.
One and only king of pop, boy. Mike Jackson.
Steve Harvey.
Pass the plate. Steve Harvey, pass the plate.
We're gonna play Steve.
Steve Harvey. Tootie?
Yeah.
Fill in the blank. I wish I had dance moves like who?
Sierra.
Sierra?
Yes!
Keita, I wish I had dance moves like who?
Usher.
Yeah. Usher. Come on, please.
I'm gonna say James Brown.
Yeah!
Good answer! Good answer!
James Brown!
Oh, wow.
Ladies, fill in the blank. I wish I had dance moves like who?
Beyonce.
There you go. Yeah. Beyonce! Five.
John Travolta.
Wow.
Four.
Jennifer Lopez.
Number one. Top eight answers on the board. Here we go. Name a game show that describes your sex life.
Family Feud.
Family Feud.
Let's make a deal.
Wow. Let's make a deal.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Nick, give me a game show that describes your sex life.
Price is Right.
Wow. The Price is Right. Jay, name a game show that describes your sex life.
Card Sharks.
Card Sharks.
That's a good answer.
Lisa, give me a game show that describes your sex life.
The Wheel of Fortune.
Wow, all right now. The Wheel of Fortune. Melinda, give me a game show that describes your sex life.
$100,000 pyramid.
$100,000 pyramid. All right, we got two strikes. Gotta be careful now, Hannah. Turn the family can steal. Give me a game show that describes your sex life.
Deal or no deal?
Oh, yeah!
Y'all, name a game show that describes your sex life.
We're gonna go with Jeopardy. Yeah.
Jeopardy. Number eight.
Match Game.
Seven. Five. What y'all doing?
Fresh your blood.
Top eight answers on the board. For you, life is not a box of chocolates. It's more like a bag of what? Natalie.
Rocks.
Bag of rocks.
Bricks.
Bricks.
We're gonna play.
Hey, Jeff, for you, life ain't a box of chocolates. It's more like a bag of what?
Candy.
Like a bag of candy. Hey, Jeff, I just. Boy, I knew that one wasn't up there. Life is not a box of chocolate, more like a bag of what? Candy. Yeah. That was up there, though. Ladina, for you, life ain't a box of chocolate, more like a bag of what?
a bag of boo-boo. I want to say something else, but can't say that, but bag of boo-boo. Sometimes.
A bag good of answer, boo-boo.
Good answer. Good answer.
I'm assuming that was the word you were looking for.
Yes, it was.
Yes. Janine, for you, life's not a box of chocolates, more like a bag of what?
Trash, Steve.
Bag of trash. Yeah! David, for you, life ain't a box of chocolates, more like a bag of what?
Chips.
Bag of chips. Natalie, for you, life ain't a box of chocolate, more like a bag of what?
Thumbtacks, Steve.
Bag of thumbtacks. Jeff, for you, life ain't a box of chocolates, it's more like a bag of what?
Weight.
That's a big man answer there, folks. That's a big man answer. For those of you that's sitting over there that's small, you don't understand what me and Jeff talking about here. Your life about a bag of weights. Just dragging extra weights. All right, Ladina. Only one strike. For you, life ain't a box of chocolate. More like a bag of what?
Like a bag of tricks.
Good answer.
When you say bag of tricks, what do you mean by that?
But like, I don't be out here playing these games. They be out here playing games, playing tricks. Okay. Life is, it don't need to be like that.
Okay, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I know exactly what you're saying.
It's just particular people.
Huh?
Certain kind of people.
Yeah,
you ain't got
that.
No tricks. For what?
No
tricks is for kids.
Silly rabbit.
Silly rabbit. Trying to tell you. You know what I'm talking about.
I hear all these tricks. I got time for this here.
Trust me.
Yes.
Got no time for these tricks. Oh. Janine, we got two strikes now. We got to be careful. We don't need them to go over there and steal. For you, life's not a box of chocolate. More like a bag of what?
Dirty laundry.
Like a bag of dirty laundry. That was a good answer. All right, family, here's your chance for you. Life ain't a box of chocolate, more like a bag of what?
Bag of marbles.
Bag of marbles!